Hello everyone, welcome to another lecture of the course Digital Signal Processing. In the previous lecture, we have seen how to design an FIR filter using windowing technique. We have said that due to sudden truncation of the ideal low pass filter, we observe ripples in the frequency domain. So if we observe this blue colored plot here, so it is the frequency domain representation due to sudden truncation, or what we call as the rectangular window. Now, in order to remove these ripples, what we had considered was a smooth truncation by using some smooth windows. So for that, after smooth truncation, the frequency domain representation, what we got was something like this, as shown by this red color plot. So this is by smooth window. And the example which we had considered was of Hanging window. Now, apart from this Hanning window, we had seen various other windows and its formulas. So let us first revise those formulas. So the first window, that is the sudden truncation, is defined by the rectangular window whose equation or the expression is given as W of n is equal to 1 for all the range of n, that is from minus m by 2 to m by 2, where this m is the order. So this M is the order of the filter. The second window which we had seen was the Hanning window, whose equation is given as W of n is equal to 0.5 plus 0.5 cos of 2 pi n by m. The third one was the Hamming window, whose equation is given as 0.54 plus 0.46 cos of 2 pi n by m. The fourth one is the Bartlett window, whose equation is 1 minus 2 times mod of n divided by m. The fifth one is the Blackman window, whose equation is given as 0.42 plus 0.5 cos of 2 pi n by m plus 0.08 cos of 4 pi n by m. Now we have many options for having smooth truncation, but we need to choose one for given specifications. So let us look at some specifications on which the choice of window depends on. So for that, we are going to consider the typical response of the ideal of the low pass filter. This is not for the ideal low pass filter, but for a truncated or FIR filter. So suppose we need to pass a particular range of frequencies, so with a particular gain, so the range of frequencies that are passed is defined as the passband. And the range of frequencies that we need to attenuate is defined as the stopband. Now the range of frequencies, or the frequency till which we need to pass the frequencies, is referred as the passband edge. So this omega p is referred as the passband edge. And the range of frequencies after which, or the frequency after which we need to attenuate or stop passing the frequencies, is referred as the stopband edge. So this omega s is the stopband edge. Now ideally, this omega p and omega s should overlap. But when we consider the practical filters, this is not the case. So we require a particular range of frequencies that is needed for transition from this passband to this stopband. So this range of frequencies in which the transition from passband to stopband occurs is referred as the transition width. So this range of frequencies is referred as the transition width. And in this case, it is defined as omega s minus omega p. Now, in this passband, we can observe some kind of ripples. So, this magnitude, this del 1, is basically referred as the passband ripple. Similarly, in the stop band, again we have ripples, and this magnitude del 2 is referred as the stop band ripple. Now we can observe that these ripples in the stop band should be ideally zero. So this del 2 should be ideally zero. But this is not the case for the practical filters. So there should be some minimum value, that is, there should be some specific value of this del 2 till which the attenuation can be tolerated. So this del 2 is basically represented in dB, which can be calculated as 20 log of del 2 to the base 10. And since this del 2 is less than 1, this del 2 is less than 1 and ideally tending to 0, this value in dB should be as high as possible in the negative direction. So this stop band attenuation or stop band ripple should be as high as possible in the negative direction, and ideally it should tend to minus infinity. Now these ripples are also some kind of lobes that are in the frequency domain. Now this pass band along with this transition width, that is this complete region, is the main lobe of the filter. Whereas these ripples, that is these ripples in the stop band, are the side lobes. And the first side lobe that is adjacent to the main lobe is referred as the peak side lobe. Now the specifications like the passband edge, the stopband edge, the transition width, the peak side lobe, then the stopband ripple or stopband attenuation allow us to choose a particular window for designing the required filter of given specifications. So whenever a client comes to us for designing a filter, what we need to ask him is some kind of specifications which are in this form. So for any filter designing, we require the specifications that are the passband edge, that is omega p, the stopband edge, that is omega s, the transition width, that can be calculated as delta omega equal to omega s minus omega p for a low pass filter, then the stopband attenuation, that is del 2 in dB, then peak side lobe, the order of the filter, that is m, and the cutoff frequency, that is omega c. So if we have these specifications available with us, we can very well design a filter by choosing an appropriate window. So in this case, the window functions should also have some kind of its own properties. So let us look at the specifications for the particular windows which we had considered. So the windows at the beginning of this lecture we had considered were of rectangular, Bartlett, Hanning, Hamming and Blackman. So for these windows, we will look at the specifications like peak side lobe, transition width, stop band attenuation. So if we consider the rectangular window, the peak side lobe is minus 13 dB. The transition width is 4 pi by m plus 1. The stop band attenuation is minus 21 dB. If we consider the Bartlett window, the peak side lobe is minus 25 dB. Then the transition width is 8 pi by m. The stop band attenuation is minus 25 dB. For the Hanning window, the peak side lobe is again reduced to minus 31 dB. The transition width is 8 pi by m. And the stop band attenuation is minus 44 dB. The Hamming window has a peak side lobe of minus 41 dB. The transition width is again 8 pi by m and the stop band attenuation is given as minus 53 dB. For Blackman window, the peak side lobe is given as minus 57 dB. The transition width is given as 12 pi by m and the stop band attenuation is given as minus 74 dB. Now if we observe the transition widths, we can see that this rectangular window has the minimum transition width. But if we look at the peak side lobe and stop band attenuation, it is quite higher than other windows. So for peak side lobe, the best result or the best value is given by this Blackman window. And moreover, for stop band attenuation also, this minus 74 dB value is quite good for the case of Blackman window, but if we look at the transition width, it is quite higher. So if we want to have better peak side lobes and stop band attenuations, what we have is a larger transition width. So there is some kind of trade-off between one and the other specifications. So if we have one specification better, we can need to compromise with some other specification. Like for the case of Blackman window, we have peak side lobe and stop band attenuation quite good. But now in this case, we need to do away with the transition width, which is quite higher as compared to other windows. So in this lecture, we have seen that we need some kind of specifications for designing filter. And these specifications include the passband edge, stop band edge, transition width, stop band attenuation, peak side lobe, order and cutoff frequency, and these specifications can be very well used to design a suitable window. So let's stop here. Thank you.